Now nature sings out of tune. Eternity, the score sheet on which the notes of nature are placed. The cosmos is the essence universal.
When reading through this book, you get a sense of how far we've come as a country. One gets to realize how many people laid up their lives in order to fight against injustices in South Africa. African people were despoiled of their minds, violated the will to resist, being degraded and despised by the world. The past history of Black Africa will remain suspended in the air and cannot be written correctly until African historians dare to connect it, warned Sheikh Anta Diop. The Sharpeville shootings of 1960. Soweto uprising, etc., etc. Shaped the destiny of South African politics to a new direction. The history of the South African political struggle can never be complete without mentioning the sacrifice that was made by Sipho Mutsu. Little did nature predict that memories of the past will be the weapon and spring that young Sipho will drink courage and inspiration from to fight for liberation of his people.
Here at King Edward VIII Hospital in Durban is where Sipho was born in 1967.
It was here at Mokgadinyana village in Lesotho, 1976, where young Sipho began his journey of being a freedom fighter.
Due to the South African Bantu education system, Sipho Mutsu, the barefooted comrade, was demoted to Standard 4 when he came back from Lesotho. Because of his intellect, he was always ahead of his peers.
He was very intelligent, fluent in English, and very artistic.
And he was more or less absent every Friday. Sometimes he would be absent for a week, and when we asked him reasons, he would say he's looking after his sick mother, and I checked that with the family and realized that the mother was never sick. Sipho, at that time, when I realized later that he was going out, you know, on Fridays he would get to the secondary school to go and debate with the high school learners, and by that time he was doing Standard 3.
He knew and talked better English than me. He also read very voluminous books which were never reading as secondary school students. I knew him also as an artist because I know even at home he had painted some beautiful Orlando Pirates logo outside our house.
He walked across the dusty streets of Kutlwanong Township, barefooted, mobilizing the young and old, with one objective in mind, liberation for his people. Inspired by a gallant spirit of those incarcerated and the will of the people to fight till the last man.
And we came across such documents as the Freedom Charter, which envisaged a particular type of society where there would be no suffering, there would be non-racialism, people wouldn't be discriminated against, etc.
Mare ha hona tla tshwana le sipo. Ka mora Freedom Charter. Ai kho. Ona sa le ka mogomong le nna gore ona na lo ntshosa ke re no. Ntho ena e fetotse motho.
On the 4th of May 1985,
Sipo was arrested by the police officer here. This was then the taxi rank.
Sipo was dragged like a sacrifice lamb through the streets of the town, with all witnessing from a safe distance, some laughing.
The attitude of the apartheid police was to obliterate any political activity. So Sipho's fate was written all over the place.
On the 5th of May 1985, Sipho's family and community woke up to his death, ushered by the cold breeze of police brutality.
The candlelight of hope to brighten the path for people's freedom was blown off by the whirlwind stirred by self-hatred of soulless natives.
Humanity shall bear testimony that here lies the son of the soil who inscripted artlessly his name into the history of mankind with his blood.
The young Sipho lost a great deal in his young life, but he served his people with dignity and honor.
The ether, a stage for a theater of the universe, where the notes of isness are a song, a dance, a vibrant kinetic movement of intergalactic theatrics of isness. The spirit of joyfulness at the pitch and zenith. Excellence. Immemorial splendor, infinite lossus naturae bedecked the ether capacious with song pomp, bordering the perfection of nothingness, the embryo of creation in which that which is and is not becomes and becometh. The music of the universe becomes partially cacophonic, with the belated introduction of a poltergeist notochord on the score sheet of the eternal, darkness visible. In the echo of light and the specter of the universe is manifested on earth, in the ether, as mana man, nature's micro wound, obu unsustained, a stained cosmic umpa to bring down solar-bound songs. And earth is now out of tune as a soloist in the solar ensemble, a vocally wounded member of the Milky Way orchestra. The syzygy fails. The air. Bound notes are flotsam jetsam caught waist floating on the wings of a bleeding moon. And once more,